The organizing committee for this Congress has compiled this rich history, revolutionary history of Kannur, in a small booklet called Kannur, the Red Land, that is being circulated to all of you, and I only appeal to all of you to just read it so that we can draw the necessary inspiration for galvanizing the party in today's conditions. And in the challenges that we face in today's conditions, it's most appropriate that this 23rd Party Congress is being held here in Kannur, and we are determined to draw the inspiration from this land in order to strengthen the Communist Party and the Communist movement in the country, which is of vital importance. Dear comrades and friends, for more than 4 years since the last Party Congress, or during these 4 years, it was exactly in April 2018 that we last met. For more than two of these 4 years, the world has been plagued, including India, by the COVID pandemic. This has wreaked havoc, disrupting the lives of millions of people. Even before this pandemic struck, the global economy as well as the Indian economy was actually on a very severe downslide, moving towards an economic recession. The pandemic worsened this situation, and during the pandemic, the economic recession that set in was marked by the lust of capitalism for profit maximization, and it completely exposed the gross inadequacy of capitalism as a system in meeting the requirements of the people, particularly in providing universal health care. In contrast, we saw the experience of the socialist countries, how they dealt with the COVID pandemic and re-energized their economies to bounce back onto a growth path. This contrast between capitalism and socialism as systems has once again established the superiority of socialism. And the conditions in India at the same time have also demonstrated that where a government led by the CPIM and LDF government in Kerala, the manner in which it had handled the pandemic had earned both domestic and international acclaim as the Kerala model, and where you have parties dedicated to the cause of the people or people-centric, then the handling of the pandemic was seen with a marked difference from what the capitalist countries did. This pincer attack of COVID and the economic recession has led to alarming levels of growth in hunger, poverty, educational deprivation, intensified exploitation of the working people, along with growing unemployment. But at the same time, given the very logic and character of neoliberalism, you find the profits of the world's millionaires rising during the course of the pandemic. That in the year 2020 alone, the total wealth of the world billionaires grew by $10.2 trillion, while the people were suffering from the various issues that are pointed out. And in India, the top 10 people, 10 individuals, during the course of the pandemic, have grown their wealth to hold 57% of our country's wealth, as opposed to the share of the bottom 50% of our people, who actually have a share of only 13% of the wealth. This is predatory capitalism at its worst that we have seen. Now, in this quest to control the government so that these predatory policies can be followed, the market political rightward shift is taking place in America. This rightward shift in politics is to ensure governments that will promote neoliberal policies and at the same time disrupt the growing unity of the working people in struggles against this double whammy attack of the pandemic and the economic recession. And this disruption, the political right seeks through appealing to emotional passions, fostering divisive appeals, promoting racism, xenophobia, religious sectarianism, fundamentalism, parochialism, and in the Indian context, communalism. This rightward shift is to sustain this neoliberal order at the same time to ensure that the unity of the working people in struggles does not reach levels where it can threaten the rule of capital itself. And that has to be prevented. This political rightward shift is the answer of the ruling classes. But this is being resisted. You have countervailing forces that have actually resisted and advanced.